Feels like pretty soon there won't be a minute of the day when we aren't being watched. Any device you own could be hacked into and used to spy on you. So what's the answer? Go completely off grid? Maybe there's another way. We could develop technology to know when we're being watched and when we truly have privacy. Steve Mann has worn a computer every day for the last 38 years. In fact, he's been called the father of wearable computing. His ideas inspired better-known devices like Google Glass. But back when he began, his digital eyeglass was so bulky, he was often the subject of ridicule.
So 35 years of digital eyeglass, and finally we see how the industry is catching on to some of these concepts. And so I feel kind of vindicated after people laugh at me for all this sort of stupid eyeglasses and crazy things. Sort of
Steve, a professor at the University of Toronto, has a cult following among his students as the original cyborg. His digital eyewear is bolted to his skull. His interest in using technology to augment what he could see began when he was a kid.
Then in the 1970s, I started to notice these things watching us and sensing us. Microwave motion detectors and burglar alarms and stuff like that. And I was wondering, well, why are all these machines spying on us?
And today, he runs an entire research team dedicated to developing technology that can sniff out when we're being surveilled.
So this device will help you identify what devices are recording your sound. So the lights over here move faster and bigger near a microphone. And then it locates the mic, and that's how you can sweep bugs.
They have devices that can pick up radio waves, including those from your cell phone.
So the radio waves coming from my smartphone here, for example, if I block that with my hand, the wave is very weak. See how weak that wave is? When it's going through my hand, and then whereas if I hold it like this, the wave is much stronger.
Perhaps his most important invention in this age of near total surveillance is technology that can detect precisely when you're being watched by a camera.
So there's a camera inside this dome, and we don't know which way it's pointing because it's shrouded in this dark dome. But the light here, when it comes into the field of view, the camera glows, and when it goes out of the field of the camera, it goes dim again. And so you can see here, it sort of paints out, if you will, the sight field of the camera. If I put my coat in front of it, my jacket, the bulb, I haven't moved the bulb at all. I've just blocked it with my jacket, and when I unblock it, it glows.
Most of us are used to seeing cameras everywhere. But Steve believes that if we knew when we were being watched, we'd start asking more questions about who's watching and why.
It could be the police, it could be a computer, it could be artificial intelligence, it could be machine learning. We often don't know. Many times surveillance embraces hypocrisy, wanting to watch and not be watched, wanting to see and not be seen, wanting to know everything about us but reveal nothing about itself.
To redress that balance, Steve is working to commercialize technology to detect the zones where a camera sees us, what he calls its valence field. Ryan Jansen is working with Steve on getting a valence field detector into a wearable device.
These are some glasses where I can see the valence fields from this surveillance camera. So what it does is pokes and prods at the optical field until it figures out how much the camera is seeing. So you can really take this around and measure a whole valence field from a surveillance camera. What I'm excited about is be able to finally see and know how much we're watched.